guys. Who's here? Who's here with me? Oh, good. I see a couple. Bets here, Jerry girl. Okay, Marie, I know you posted. I hope you can join. Leafson might be here. All right, you guys, welcome, welcome. Let me know you're here. Give me a laugh, a share, a roar. As we just get started, let me know you're here in the comments if you want, and let me know where you are. I'm in Belize. It's getting hot here. It's getting hot. So, hey, Jessica, welcome. Hi, Susan. Oh, good. Yay. Roar from Jerry. Awesome. If you have groups or friends or pages that you think might be interested in this healing today, then please go ahead and share it. Share this video with them so we can get the healing out there to the people. Hi, Catherine. Welcome. I don't think you've been on one of my lives before. I'm excited to see you. Awesome, Susan. Thanks for sharing. Jessica's cold in New Jersey. Yep. So I'm from Seattle, and they've been having nice days. Jerry, you'll have to tell me what it's like now. But Illinois for Bet, good. Gosh, they were having huge snow. So okay, I'm gonna just. Actually, I'm not gonna mess with the Facebook unless I end up not seeing the comments here. Oh, Trinidad. Oh, yep. Yep. Oh, I've always wanted to go to Trinidad. I grew up with a kid who lived in Trinidad and Tobago. So that was always fun to know about. Today, I'm going to work with the basic, strong, clear crystal quartz, just so you guys know. We're going to use this. This is the one that jumped out at me to use for the healing today. So, okay. Welcome. I'm going to jump right in. So I'm Jill Hoyrup. I'm a master psychic and intuitive healer and coach. I help people tap into the energetic patterns and blocks that are underlying, right? Those underlying energetic patterns that attach to what's really going on in your reality. So we can clear those out and help you move forward in your life. So that's what I do. And then I also figured out I'm a teacher. Whoop! I guess I should have listened to those questionnaires back in the day. And so I'm now a teacher mentor, and I teach people how to tap into their intuition and their spiritual gifts. I just started tapping into mine in 2003 when I was introduced to energy healing. I'd always lived in my head for like 33 years of my life. So huge change to start understanding. The more I learned about my intuition and my gifts, the more my childhood made sense to me. So I like to help people figure out, you know, where they're at with their gifts, what their gifts are, how to improve them, what to do with them, if they want to do anything with them, and things like that. So that is a little bit about me. Hi, Tammy. Ooh, carnival and Trinidad. Catherine, that sounds dangerous. Oh, good. Jerry's saying it's mid-70s in Seattle. Oh, good. Yay. So Catherine saw me in another group. It's called Divine Love and Light, and she saw my post. So, oh, at 11:11. Oh, perfect timing. Yep, it's meant to be. Oh, Marie made it. Yay. Hi, Marie. Okay, awesome, you guys. So we're doing a super full moon and equinox healing ceremony today. And I love doing things at new moons or full moons or anytime really, there could be other reasons too. Those are the two main ones. But when the energy is just like ripe for the picking, like I just love it because you can really use the energies of the moon phases, new moon and full moon in particular, eclipses, like today's a super moon or today, tomorrow's, depending where you are, super moon. There are powerful energies that you can tap into to really help you release things or manifest things or clear things. Clearing's like released. So just keep that in mind as we go through this. I'm going to get rid of this thing now. So I'm going to be helping us I'm going to be facilitating this, right? So we're all going to be tapping into these energies. You're going to be doing your own individual work on your own side, where you are, what you're doing. If anybody is on the replay, go ahead and do a hashtag replay. And if you have any questions, you can let me know and I'll get back to the post and answer. But it should be pretty smooth sailing for us. Like I said, we're using this clear crystal quartz today. This is like a great, basic, powerful stone to use in any kind of healing. What crystals do, I'm not going to go into a whole lot about them now, but what they do is they help magnify what you're trying to do. And they help bring the energy. And they can also, like this is a pointed one. You can see this little point on it. They actually help guide the energy. So if we are going to do a release, I might hold it in a certain way. Like say I'm doing something on my body, I might hold it, say my heart chakra, can you see? So there's the point. So I might be holding it that way in order to send the stuff, junk, whatever, out of my heart chakra so that I don't have to keep carrying that around, for example. Okay, so I'm just using this in general. Okay, welcome. Thank you for sharing, Catherine. I appreciate it. All right, so let's take a couple deep breaths. My guides always like to say to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. So if you want to follow along with that, you can do so, or breathe your own way. We're just connecting with ourselves with this breath, and we're also connecting with each other. Perfect. So let's tap into ourselves a little bit and think about what is it. We don't even have to actually know what this is, okay? You never have to know because you're working with energy. So it doesn't have to be defined. It can just be a blanket intention about releasing all that doesn't serve you, whatever doesn't serve you in your best and highest good. It can be something specific. If you know, like some of you know, I've been dealing with this horrible tooth infection that's still around. It's seems to be coming back now that I'm off antibiotics. So last year, you know, might've been a big energetic kind of not fun year for a lot of people. So just think about what's going on in your life. And when we talk about releasing, it can be, you know, people, places, things, attitudes, beliefs, behaviors. It doesn't really matter. It can be anything that you want. So just tune into, and if you want to share in the comments what you are actually going to be releasing, you know, there's power in declaring it. If it's personal and you don't want to, that's totally fine too. So I'm going to be releasing stuff around health, and maybe that's connected to beliefs and things like that. And I'm also going to throw in there for myself, just kind of a general, just anything that doesn't serve my highest good and highest purpose. Okay. So how's everybody doing with, is everybody still here? I haven't seen any comments. Oh good, the comments are up front. Okay, so let me know. Give me an emoji if you're still on and following me, and you can send a comment if you have something that you're definitely plan on releasing. So we're just gonna tap into this energy. And let's see, so I'm going to be connecting it to everybody too. That's cool. So this is the first part, guys. This is the release. So we're connecting into everything that everybody wants to release. I just got a huge hit of it, and it's pretty big stuff. I'm feeling kind of a rush all at once. So let me get my little trapdoor to the universe open. So whenever we do a release, we set it up so it doesn't harm anyone else. And so it can go back to where it belongs and be recycled. I'd call it recycling because it's a word we understand. You know, recycle it back into the universe. So every healer has their own way of setting it up, something safe to do this. So just want you to know all your stuff is going to be going somewhere where it won't come back. We can come back and get you. Okay. Awesome. So Marie's working on impatience. That's a good one. That is a good one indeed. So, okay. Yeah. So what I'm picking up for you, sorry, it's a little side note, Marie, if you don't mind, is like, I'm sensing like some overthinking and some, it seems like your thoughts are very involved with, and there's a little piece of control factor with the thinking. I don't know if that resonates with you at all. But it might help you to slow down a little bit and lower expectations as well as stop thinking. Stop thinking instead of, start feeling instead of thinking. That was like the biggest, best thing I ever learned when I was studying Abraham Hicks back in the day. Okay, Catherine is releasing hurt from betrayal and attacks and blockages to my abundance, other psychic stuff that's ready to go. Perfect. Jessica's overthinking. Yes. Thoughts. Yes. Perfect. Okay. Good. Good, good, good. Yeah. Okay. So if you know what it is, you can tune into it and tell yourself and tell your energetic self, tell your guides, tell your angel spirits, all of your spiritual support staff to help you in this release. Okay. And if you want to pull in archangels and all that, whoever you use, whatever you want to use, your animal totems, all of that. Jerry's working on not letting others' negative energy and attitude affect my life and her authenticity. I love that one. Yes. Okay, good. You guys are powerful human beings. Okay. Let's tap into this now. So connecting us up to the super full moon energy. Are you guys starting to feel that shift? If you're a feeler, like you might feel this kind of intensity. I feel a lot of intensity and I feel like my head wants to go like this. It's like a, so that's good. We're tapping in. So I am tapping into all the things you're wanting to release. And we're asking that now to release, to be let go. No judgment. No, wait, I miss you. Come back. You can pull it back if you want. Please don't. It can show up in a different way. Let's get this layer out. Let's get this layer of stuff out for you guys. Okay. Tune into your breathing a little bit, in through the nose and out through the mouth. And it's really good because there's just enough of you on that I'm actually tapping into each of you individually. And if you're not actually in the comments, I'm still feeling you energetically, even though I don't know who you are necessarily. And I can see it in its energetic form and I can feel it for you and help it move out. So the way this will work on the replay is very similar. It's like a healing in advance, right? The intention is there and the container has been set for this healing. So that's why it works on a replay as well. Okay. That's feeling really good, you guys. There's what I'm seeing is actually like a river of energetic stuff. I know my big professional word. And it's just flowing. It's flowing straight to that trapdoor of the universe. And it's just, it's a soft, gentle flow. So hopefully you're feeling that in your own release. Although some of you have bigger things to release than others, but in general, it's not like big and clunky or blocked. It's just a nice, soft, gentle flow, which to me indicates that you're ready to let it go and that it's easy for you to let it go. It could be something that you've been thinking about for a long time that you want to let go of. And I'm going like this, sorry, I'm too low. You can't see me, but I'm going like this with my hand because that's how it feels. It feels like it's just flowing like a little stream just flowing down. So tune into that and sense it if you can. Some of you may actually be seeing your stuff being released, which is always cool to have that extra confirmation. Okay. This kind of feels like a big one for us. I'm going to keep going a little bit longer. So just keep breathing because we're going to be doing an intention setup after this. So I'm sending this crystal to each of you energetically, and we're actually, for you on the replay, and we are just giving it that extra little zap. There it goes. Okay. Catherine, for you, I'm getting, if you have an amethyst, to use that a little bit over the next week to really help kind of break up. I'm going to send you some energy, Catherine, for breaking up those different things you want to release, because you feel like you have a kind of a big one in a few different areas. So if you have an amethyst, you can even just call in the energy of an amethyst. And just carry it with you in your pocket or your purse, or have it out on your desk when you're working, or whatever your situation, just have it around you in the car while you're driving, and just embrace that amethyst. I feel like that's going to help you, especially with the betrayal piece. And what I'm sending to you, Catherine, is this this energy to help break up that. To me, it just seems like it's a big boulder that's on you. It's all right here in your torso. And it's just, I'm sending it energy to help break it up, break up that, I'm calling it a boulder. That's what I see. So break it up. It's just showing me it's a big mass of energy. So the amethyst, and then this extra unraveling, energy of unraveling. Ooh, Michelle is on. Hi, Cindy's on. Alejandra's on. Awesome, you guys. Welcome, welcome. Yay, Catherine's saying it feels delicious to let all of this go. Hot diggity dog. Oh, good. Jerry's back. Okay, so we're still just doing our clearing, you guys. We're using the clear quartz crystal. And so for those of you who are just hopping on, just do some breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. And think about what you want to release. If you don't know what that is, just, you can have a general, I want to release everything, whatever isn't in my best and highest good. And releasing can be person, place, or thing, a job, an attitude, a belief, a thought, a behavior, all that stuff. So it doesn't matter what it is. You don't have to tell us. If you want to share, you can. Whew. Okay, so let's continue. This has been kind of a big one for us. So we're tapping into the energies of the full moon and the equinox. Really, it's the super full moon energies we're tapping into the most. So we're helping we're using those energies to help facilitate this release. Okay, we're almost done with the release, and then we're going to zap up our intentions. Love zapping up. Okay. All right, good. So continue. There it is. Catherine, you just dumped a couple of those pieces from the boulder. Yay. So that's really awesome. Yeah. I don't know if you feel a shift or not, but I kind of feel like you just like relaxed. You just, you know, like, I don't know if you've been holding your shoulders up like this, but that was like, I actually just physically did that because I felt like that's what you were doing, it like holding all this tension and all this stress and all this experience, right? So just, in fact, you might actually even want to just even get a shoulder massage or just rotate, you know, and even you can pull your arms up even. I just feel like there's something with your shoulders to have it release more. Okay. I hope you guys don't mind when something jumps out at me like that. I do share it. So you might know some things you weren't expecting. All right. All right. I'm feeling like we're about done here. How's everybody feeling? Shoot me a emoji or comment that correlates with how you feel. Oh, good. Catherine says she's feeling it and she's getting help from her dragons. Awesome. Let's see. I'm going to test something. Okay. Okay, good. Cool. All right. Feeling good. All right. Let's finish this up. Do a few more really releasing breaths for me. Deep. Here we go. Awesome. Great job, everybody. All right. I'm just watching that finish up. Okay, cool. Oh, Marie's feeling great. Yay. I'm feeling pretty mellow right now. That was a lot of energy and just stuff, you know? Awesome. Alejandra's letting go of limited beliefs and attitudes that are holding me back. Good. Michelle feels pixelated. I like that one. I like it. Yeah. Okay. Well, my head stopped feeling like I wanted to move forward. So good. Okay. Awesome. All right. I've still got the crystal here, guys. So let's shift gears a little bit and start working on our intention. So get centered and grounded again here for a minute. Oh, hey, everybody, have some water. Always important to have water handy when you do energy healing. So throughout today, drink more water. Drink even water after you think you've already had enough water, drink more water. Okay, so let's think now about our intentions. And so yeah, Michelle's saying she maybe it's fragmented. Yeah, putting my junk into the earth. Perfect. Yeah. That definitely resonates with me for you. So moving forward to our intention. So now it's like we have a little bit more of a clean slate, right? As we've just done that big clearing. So let's tap into what is it we really want to intend? What's our intention? What do we want to manifest? What do we wish for? What do we want to create? Whichever word that you want to use. Let's tap into that a little bit. So for me, since I just released stuff about my health, I'm going to go ahead and stay with that intention just because it's what's going on with me right now. So I want to create that space for more health, right? Especially in regards to my tooth infection. So it can also be something that you aren't working on now, but you want to see start manifesting in your life. So that could be job or career or abundance type stuff, or I don't know why this is popping out at me for someone, maybe myself, haha. Tapping into how people treat you, how you want to be treated, how you want to be seen, how you want to feel. Those are something, I don't know if this is resonating with anybody, but that's what's coming in. So let me know if that sounds like you, if you want to share, if you want to share what you are intentioning. What is your intention? Share it below. And we do have fun here, you guys. So thank you for being here. All right. So let's get in alignment with our intention. Okay. And we've got our crystal we're still working with. Okay, good. Jerry's saying that resonates. Okay, awesome. Yeah, it resonates for me too. So it could be for me, but I also felt it was for someone else. Hence, I said it out loud. So, all right. So this intention piece is all about the way we're going to use the full moon, super full moon energy is to bring that energy in. And it's a little term I've coined called zapping it up. And what you do with this energy and this intention is you let the energy work with the intention to literally magnify this intention that you have. So I've helped people get jobs. That's like the biggest one with this intention, zapping it up, and money, Christmas bonuses when they weren't expecting it and stuff like that. So it's really a powerful tool to be able to incorporate these energies in with what you are trying to create. That's why it's so powerful to go out into the new moon energy or the full moon energy, and people do, ceremonies or rituals under the moon. You can charge your crystals out in the moon, and it's powerful. It's powerful stuff. It's very healing energy, this moon energy. So if you can find a way to start working with it on your own even more, you will be amazed at, what kinds of things you start manifesting. All right. So Michelle is working on job and career for husband, retired. Okay. He's retired from the Army, job searching. Michelle's saying, I intend for him to find the new career that makes him happy and wealthy. And it happens by May 15th. I like that. I'm getting a yes that it will, by the way, Michelle. We're not really doing readings right now, but I can't help it. When the info comes through, you get some answers. So yeah, that's a good one. All right, good. Anybody else? Because then I'll tap into you specifically for that. I mean, I will anyway. Helps everybody get, and if you want to have a general intention, you can do that too. So you can do a general intention, say, let's get one, for example, of, hi, Judy. You can do a general one for, say, I'm trying to think of a general one. Of course, my mind is blank right now. A general one for maybe, how about just feeling good? Feeling good? Feeling positive. Maybe that's another one. I've actually been working on my self-talk a lot lately because I've kind of gotten down in the dumps with this tooth infection. So like kind of revamping and whatnot. Okay, Judy's got a intention for her beautiful blooming business. I love it. All right, so let's do our breathing. Oops, what happened? Alejandra's doing more abundance. Perfect. Okay, so I'm just tuning in again. And again, this is going to work the same way for those of you on the replay. And so we'll just tune in advance. Cool. Okay. Everybody's ready to go. Well, I'm actually seeing the energy come from the universe and the moon and zap you guys. Cool. Well, it's making its way through. It's still on the first person right now. So feel the zaps. Be open to the intention, okay? Start aligning your energy and your thoughts with this intention. There you go. Okay. You don't have to know how this is going to happen. You just believe and have faith and connect to the energy of it happening. And Michelle, for you, I want to add to do a visualization. I don't know if your husband would be on board with this. You can do it yourself, but it'll be more powerful if he does it too. Start doing a visualization of, you know, you guys talking together, and he gets, you might actually have to start it earlier than getting the job started at, you know, looking in the paper or looking, listen to me, looking on the paper. Ah, does anybody look at the paper anymore for jobs? Okay. Anyway, looking for a job. Start at the beginning of him, like see it like a movie where he's looking for the job. He applies, you know, he finds the job. He applies for the job. He has the interview for the job. He gets the call that he got the job. Okay, take it through the whole process, because right now the energy for this job for your husband's kind of scattered. And what we need to do, I'm actually going to do it for you right now, is pull it together and ground it in him, because it is out there. But I think there's a little piece of your husband that's like, is it really going to happen? And he's so used to Army stuff. So I'm going to actually zap that job that it like basically like punches him in the face energetically. Like, this is it. This is the job. So, okay, let's just get you. I'm getting all the goosebumps. Okay. So yeah. So start this visualization, Michelle, where you are excited, like, ooh, that he found it. And then you're excited. Part of it is getting into the feeling of this. Oh, good. Yes. Okay. Awesome. And Michelle, I think you would actually do this. Start like, even have a day where you like look at him and be like, honey, you got the job. And then you grab his hands and you jump up and down in the kitchen or living room or wherever you are. And you're like, I got it. I got it. And you know, raise your hands and you just celebrate it, right? Maybe put on a song and dance and do a jig and like really get that. There's a kinesthetic part and point of getting the body involved in that intention and in that visualization and manifestation. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. Yeah, I know you're gonna let me know how that goes, because you could just make it fun, make it a game, make it up. We're not worried about the how it happens. We're just putting it out there and we're just knowing that it's coming to us. And that's part of the intention process. I'm just laughing. I'm just seeing you in advance doing this. So I'm kind of cracking up. Okay, Catherine's working on more clients in Twin Flame. Marie felt it in her hands when we were doing it. Cool. All right. Catherine's got love, light, harmony, and more expansion. Ooh, I like those. Those okay. Jerry's working on flip side. When you move from the positive to the negative. Judy's working on general health choices. And we already said this, but Alejandra is more abundance. Okay, cool. All right. Is everybody feeling it? What's everybody feeling right now? We're not done yet, but I'm just going to do a little check-in. I'll continue while you write your comments. Okay, that was good. So just to finish up, Michelle, your whole thing now for your husband's job is all like connected. Like, it's not scattered anymore. It's connected. And if he hasn't done it already, he might want to write like what's in the perfect job list. And I am talking about duties and whatnot for the job. I'm not worried about title or position, but I'm more wanting him to write down how he wants to feel at that job, what kind of people he wants to be around, what size of company, what kind of commute, that kind of stuff to really solidify this. But there is one jumping out at me. So cool. Okay, good. Oh, awesome. Michelle's hands are on fire and her heart is skipping. Woo-hoo. Yay. Gigi's on the right track. Okay. All right. So let's see. I'm just checking in with everybody. Okay. So we're not done yet. Still working on the intention setting. Energetic intention setting. Zapping it up, you guys. So think about what you're intending. Think about what you want to manifest. And we are connecting the full moon, super full moon energy Equinox energy, strong energies going on right now to this intention, okay? So I'll need to report back on how this unfolds over the next week, right? Maybe longer than that for some of you with some things, but you might notice off the bat, if you're talking about, like Jerry's talking about being authentic, and look, now she's already saying, getting ideas on how to move forward. Well, that was fast. Okay, don't wait a week, tell me now. she's getting ideas on how to move forward. Yep, things, people, activities in my life individually to keep me positive. Perfect. I love that. So that's what we're talking about. So that could be more what Jerry gets from this, right? So just be aware, just start noticing these little things. If you're talking about more abundance and more clients, like Catherine was, then just start noticing like, wow, I heard from someone new today. Where did they come from? Oh, they're zapping it up. Cool. So Judy's working on a visionary book writing for spirit guided book projects. I love that. That's really cool. Yay, Judy. Okay, so how's everybody doing? How's everybody feeling? I'm just tapping in again. Okay, so even if you haven't written down your intentions, you guys, I'm still tapping into you, okay? So I just want you to know that it's okay that you don't share, and I'm still picking up on stuff and still working with you energetically on what that is. So we're giving everybody a zap it up for their intention. Judy, I feel like that project is really going to kind of springboard you to something. So keep that in mind, that it feels like, I don't know, it feels like a foundation of something for something more. So I like it. Okay. Dana's working on, my thing moved. Yay. I mean, I can still do yay from Judy. go full force on developing jewelry business that I've put off. Yes. This is a great time to do that for you, is what I'm getting, Dana. Ooh, Michelle's getting a vibe for Judy to do her own oracle cards. I like that. So Judy, that sparked me because I was online looking at something. It was something that came up on an ad on my phone, and they were little cards for writing tips. And I don't know that you would want to do that. I like the oracle, like maybe it's oracle cards for writers. I don't know. And it doesn't have to just be for writers, but I know that's your thing. Hey, Michelle, welcome. Okay, she is dreaming big. Her intention is to be a healthy, happy billionaire. I like it. Okay, we're tapping into all of this. That's you make me smile, Michelle. That's fun. Okay. Zapping everything up for everybody. If you want to join in the breathing, you can. In through the nose and out through the mouth. There we go. And if you're joining us for the intention piece and you didn't do the release piece, it's okay. You didn't have to do the release piece first necessarily. So there it goes. Awesome. Guys, it feels so good. So what I'm feeling right now is a real like calm, grounded, integrated feeling. Is anyone else feeling that? And tingle, like I was getting tingles with Catherine's stuff, but like, how's everybody doing? How's everybody feeling? And one thing too is, like I just tried to tap into my own intention of the tooth infection stuff, and I couldn't really find it. Is that happening for anybody where it's kind of like you can't think of it because it's a moot point? It doesn't matter. It's happening. It's already happening. What do you guys feel about that? And that'll happen when you let it go, right? That happens when you let things go. It's like you try to find it, try to think about it, and it's not there. Let me know if anybody else has that. Judy, you have your first customer. Michelle's going to buy a deck. I love it. You guys are awesome. Okay, Beth's intention is to be truly happy, peaceful life, and motivation to help others. I love that. Dana's getting a yes. Judy's feeling calm and powerful. Hot diggity dog. Oh, I just got a bunch of more comments. Okay. Cindy's feeling okay. Yay. Michelle's like a vortex in a ball with all the energy. Yeah. Suzanne's feeling very calm, warm and very calm. Yep, you might be feeling warm. And if you're feeling cold, that's okay too, because that's also a sign that the energy is clearing. Peace for Marie. Awesome. Yay. Yay. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna wrap it up here in a couple minutes. That feels so good. I don't even know if I have anything more to say. I'm so mellow right now. Who has anything? Anything else from anybody? If anybody wants to and hasn't yet, you can join the Facebook group, hashtag Ignite Your Intuition. It's where we practice our gifts, learn about our gifts if you don't know what they are already. And if you want to learn more about me, you can go to jillicious.com. I am the Jill in Jillicious. And I'm feeling so good, you guys. Oh, more water. More water. I'm doing an ad for water. Thank you to Judy too. Thank you guys. Yeah, that was great. That was a big, huge release, you guys. Be proud of yourselves because you really let it all go. And a lot of people don't want to let it go. So I'm really, really proud of you for allowing me to help facilitate you letting it go. So that's huge, 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 huge. Yay, Alejandra feels good. Thank you guys for sharing the video, for any friends or pages or groups of people that might be interested in something like this. I will be back again. I'll be starting to do these once a week, not a big full moon clearing, obviously, but I do like the full moon, new moon. So we'll do a healing and we'll get back to the readings and whatnot here on the Jillicious page. So please come find me. If you haven't already liked or shared the page, please do, if you feel so inclined. Okay, be gentle with yourselves. I feel like I kind of need a nap a little bit. You're welcome, Jerry. I know, good way to start the day, huh? Does this seem to be a good time for everybody? You're welcome, Bet. Oh, drink your water, you guys. Look at me. Water maniac. You're welcome, Marie. Thank you, guys. Oh, if you missed anything, you can be sure to catch the replay. Hashtag replay. Whew, okay, have a super good day, you guys. I love you. Mahalo. Have fun and continue to roar.